3.6 million people in the United States do not obtain medical care due to transportation issues each year, according to a report from the American Hospital Association. The COVID-19 pandemic compounded the issue and forced communities to face unprecedented challenges. Many systems such as transportation, healthcare, financial, and energy delivery struggled to meet society's increased demands. Siqian Shen, an associate professor in the Department of Industrial and Operations Engineering at the University of Michigan, quickly applied her expertise in computation and modeling to improve transportation systems that bolster a community's ability to fight COVID-19.
The problem here is how can you redesign these systems such that you can still transport people from point to point, at the same time can reduce the risk they have been exposed to others during the rides. All these decisions involve, you know, like a human behavior, and that's one part of the transportation system. The other part is the underlying infrastructure, the networks that guide the vehicle flow and the human flow, you know, to use different types of transportation resources.
Understanding overall demand and knowing the primary hubs where people are coming from and traveling to is important.
So these hubs are going to be the ones that a lot of people are trying to get on the bus in these locations and trying to get off the bus there. And once you have these hubs, basically you can use very frequent buses to connect them so that you can transport a lot of people in very short amount of time. However, there will be people not living close by the hubs, and you have to create extra routes to take people from the hubs to their final destinations. So this kind of design is what we call hub and spoke design, which is essentially a network model that you're trying to design the underlying network, the underlying infrastructure of the transportation network, such that you can achieve certain efficiency of your operations.
Researchers must also consider people driving their own cars, using ride sharing, and in some cases other public transit options, such as using the subway, when planning more complex transportation solutions.
So you can see that these system questions are all connected. The resource allocation question, which is where you're going to route all these buses, where you're going to find the drivers, are connected to how do you design the underlying infrastructure, and also further connected to how do you operate these vehicles in the design systems.
Optimizing systems requires many diverse skill sets, from understanding data science techniques to break down demand patterns, to using graph theory to design hub and spoke models, and building up models using mathematics and developing computational algorithms to solve for solutions, often using high-performance computing.
And then once you have the solution, you also have to put them into simulation platform to mimic what's going to happen in the future and try to enumerate all possible scenarios that you can face and test the resilience of the system.
With the COVID-19 pandemic, if without computers, there was no way to solve the problems in these small time frames that we needed to, even just how to distribute food, how to distribute the vaccines, how to get ambulance around a city. You have too much information, and without algorithms and computational science, there was no other way to do it.
The University of Michigan has a long history of using computational science and high-performance computing to design complex integrated systems that improve our quality of life, and will continue seeking solutions to the issues faced by communities long into the future.